Hello, it is a Saturday evening. I thought I would take you along with me in a fun, creative evening. I have been sat here reading this book and I'm very much enjoying it. It's by Will Gompertz. I might be saying the name wrong, but I thought I just wanted to talk to you real quickly about chapter 4, which is Artist Steal. I haven't finished the book yet. The first chapter I wasn't really vibing with, and now I'm really enjoying it. Also, there's something really cool here, because there's a little quote from Ecclesiastes 1:9, which I think really does encapsulate the point that this chapter is trying to make, because, you know, I don't think this person is a particularly sort of religious person based on some of the things I'm reading in this book, but like, I just think it's really cool that we have a quote from Ecclesiastes 1:9. Like, the Bible is so prolific that it's just applicable to everything in all circumstances. So I think using a quote from something that you don't necessarily like believe in, you know, really does highlight this point of artist steal and kind of take. And a couple of things that I really, really loved about this is that it really breaks down this process of writing and this definition of what an idea is really nice. So basically, he talks a bit about how basically an idea is the combination of two seemingly unrelated entities drawn together to share the same spatial area, essentially. So it's about, you've got two ideas, they're seemingly unconnected, and you bring them together in a new, or unexpected way, and that's how we get an idea. So he kind of starts on a micro level about talking about like a metaphor, for example. So he uses this sentence of like, I think the sentence is, the road was like a rocket of sunlight. And he's like, okay, this is a really interesting metaphor. How did we get this idea? We start with two seemingly disconnected ideas of a road and a rocket. They're pleasing in terms of like sound and that kind of thing. And then the writer was like, how can I bring them together? What do they have in common? Okay, I'm thinking of sunlight. And now we weave them together to make this metaphor. I think slowing down the process of where an idea comes from is quite an interesting thing to do. I think it's really easy as a writer to be like, I've got an idea and off we go. But actually thinking about like, okay, where did this idea come from? Which ideas am I mashing together? Sometimes it's really clear, you know, when you pitch a book, for example, you might say, this is Star Wars meets Romeo and Juliet, which as I'm saying, that sounds really interesting. Or you might say, this is this book meets this book. And sometimes that's hard for writers to do because they're like, I don't know, I just had the idea. But if you think about it, you never really create in a vacuum. So I really like that. Something else I really like is that a lot of the examples in this book are from like visual artists. There's some performance artists in there as well, but like this whole chapter is really talking about Picasso. And as someone who doesn't have a wealth of knowledge when it comes to visual art, this is really, really interesting to me. I'm learning a lot. I love the process of making art from various mediums. They're always so similar, right? And so I'm learning about visual artists, about Michelangelo, about Picasso. Hello. You know when you're just trying to use the last of your vegetables and you're like, how can I be creative with what I've got? So we're about to make dinner. It's gonna taste good. It's just we're literally using the last of the... I'll show you what I've got. We have these, and we have, obviously some spices, because mama didn't raise no spiceless girl. You know what I'm saying? You'll know what I'm saying. Classes this morning, and what we do is we send these videos so that the students' parents can watch them back, so basically that they've got homework to do during the week and stuff. So I need to film those videos and upload them, so I'm just gonna do them now. They don't take very long, and it's all fresh in my mind because obviously I taught this morning, and that was fun. So let's film those. Hello, well done for class today. I was really, really impressed with your work, particularly by the solo pieces that we did towards the end of class. So to recap quickly, we were looking at physical expression. So I'm here with my laptop. I run a theatre company and we have a company email and I need to jump on and check some emails and respond to some people. So that's what we're doing now. I'll speak to you in a bit. Okay, so there were around 850 entries.